Okay, so what is KML? That's the big question here. And how do we make it and how do we bring it into our Google Map API, Google Maps API? And so what I want to do in this tutorial here briefly is basically just review quickly what KML is and what it can do, and then show you how to make it in Google Maps, just the online version of Google Maps. And then I'm going to show you a trick so you can actually create it with pictures embedded. Currently, the new Google Maps doesn't allow you to export KML with the photos embedded, but the old version does. So I'll show you how to do that. And then hopefully, if we have time in this tutorial, I'll show you how to import a KML with the JavaScript API quickly. All right, so first things first, what is KML? Let's see, I have to find my. Well, first of all, KML stands for Keyhole Markup Language. Keyhole is basically a company that Google purchased back in 2004, 2005, around there. And they were developing what is now Google Earth. And they developed a language, a file type. Don't even think of it as a language, really. Think of it as a file type, a spatial file type, like a shape file or a geodatabase, basically that would load in their Earth viewer. And so they called it KML because it's based on the XML language and or scripting, and basically it stood for Keyhole Markup Language, and it still does. And what it does is it's data, and a lot of GISs open it, but primarily it was made for Google Earth, and Google Earth can open it, and you can come in points, it can have areas and polygons, you can have line data, etc. And it's an overlay. So we call them layers in GIS. Overlays is generally the term used in online APIs, and you can turn them, overlays on and off, make them visible or not. So this is Google Earth. All right, I'll close that. No. And then, what does it look like actually? How is it created? Well, actually, what's incredible about it is that it is just XML. So see up here, if you can open any KML file in a text editor, it's just a text file, just like HTML is. And up here we can see it's an XML version 1, and then it's using the KML tags that are available here. So it tells it where to load the XML tags that it'll be using at this opengis.net KML. And basically, it's just like HTML. It's a markup language, so you basically use tags, and all of this data is written as text. So you can create KML with a text editor. Would you want to? Probably not. Although there are probably some diehard gurus out there that would like to. The more complicated it gets, the more markup language you have. So here we see things like place mark, name, polygon. So this will be a polygon. And here are coordinates for each point in the polygon. All of this here, information that you'll find in the info windows, the name, the image embedding, etc. So KML, think of it as just a spatial data file, but do realize that it's actually a text file, just like a lot of other good things on the web. It can be edited in a text editor, and it's very simple, and it's very easy to manipulate. All right. So with that being said, let's go to Google Maps. Now, where do we get KMLs? Can we create them? Well, you can create them in a lot of ways. I believe you can export them straight from ArcGIS, so you can export data as KML. That might not be true because I don't have ArcGIS on this machine and I use other GISs. Global Mapper can export KML. Avanza Map Publisher can export KML. And almost all GISs can open KML now because it's very, very common. However, to create KML, like I said, you can write it in a text editor, but how tedious. So the way I like to create KML is to use an online resource. Now, you can use Google Earth to create KML. You can add points and stuff, and that's one option. But some computers don't have Google Earth, and sometimes it's nice to just be sitting at home on your computer, on your couch, if you have a couch, if you don't have a couch, on the floor, wherever, and create it. So one really neat thing that you can do is Google Maps, just maps.google.com, has this option where if you log in with a Google account, and yes, Google does track everything you do, so I recommend making a bunk account that you use for nothing but basically using Google. And this is the Chrome browser version. It might look different, and Google is always changing things, but in every version of Google Maps, there's a way to get to My Custom Maps. And you can click here, and you can create your own maps. How incredible. Now, I'm not going to go into the details of this because it's pretty self-explanatory. But I will zoom in on my favorite place in the whole world, Nyíregyháza, Hungary, and show you, you know, what you can do. You can add a point, and da-da-da-da-da, and you can embed a picture. You can even use Google search. I don't think I have to write Hungary after that. There probably aren't many Nyíregyházas. Look at that t-shirt. A little nationalist, but whatever. So, let's save. You can draw polygons. Here are the lakes that I swam in that are full of Chernobyl gunk. Lakes full of Chernobyl gunk. All right. The coolest thing is when you're done, you can go up here and export as a KML. And when you do that, you can pick layers and stuff. I'm not going to get into it. You can hit download, and you can save this KML file. And voila, it creates it for you. So you don't have to do all the text editing, etc. Now, here's the problem. So if you double-click on it, normally by default, if you have Google Earth installed, it'll load right in Google Earth. You can always right-click on it and say open with text editor. So I want to, hey. Well, there's another problem, isn't there? It's not even letting me. So the info windows aren't exactly showing up here. That is kind of a problem. And also, if they were to show up, which they should, but of course, whenever you're demoing something, rule number one about demoing is it'll never work. No matter how many times you've tested it, the pictures won't show up. So the pictures with this Google Earth, this Google Maps creator, though they embed here and you can export as an iframe or embed on my site and export this map as an iframe, they'll show up, but not if you export the KML. And I don't know why Google is doing this. Quite honestly, I don't. Because with Google Maps, it was possible until this new version came out to do this. I think what they're doing is they're going to start charging for this feature. So let me show you the workaround. So I've exported this file already, but the photos aren't in it. Golly gee, I don't want to redigitize everything. So let's go back to straight up Google Maps. So before we went into my custom maps and all of this, before I clicked on that, just at maps.google.com, I'll do it again, just so you see what I mean. So you got to get out of this editing program here. I'll just close it. So I'm going to go down here to the settings tab, and this is the settings tab in every browser. Look for the little gear thing. That's Google's settings thing. And I'm going to go to My Places. Now, My Places is what the old Google Maps called this, you know, create custom maps. Now, this is important too. So I have all my maps here, that's great. But if you click on any of these, they'll probably open in the new map creating interface. So don't go to create map or anything, go to or create with classic my maps. And we'll click on there and we'll call Nyíregyháza revamped. We'll make it public, that'll be important later. We'll hit save. Now, import. With the new version of Google Maps, you can't import KML or GeoRSS feeds. You can only import CSVs or XLSs. So basically, they're making it less free, but they're not calling it that. But with the old version, you could import KMLs. So if you've created your digitized your stuff in the new interface, which is much better, you can go here and you can import Nyíregyháza. And it imports your data. This is the brilliant thing. Then here, you can actually, in this interface, this old interface, you can tweak the info windows. Now, like I said, it's a little bit clunkier, but actually you have more control. So I'll call this my first, cigarette. Yeah, sorry. Actually, it wasn't there. If you click on rich text, you can, you know, basically edit it how you want. You can change the font a little, change the color of the font. You can embed photos. Here you'll have to have upload your folders to your assets folder. But let's try Hopefully I remember where I have a photo online. All right. Don't think that one worked. But here. Go to images. Oh, yay, Cloudhasa. So I'll just copy that image. I'll just delete this puppy. Oh, I can't. See? This is why I should copy image URL. Screwed up. I'm getting flustered. All right, there we go. So we got the image in there. We could add italics or bold. Nyek, Ladhaza Lakes. So basically, the old interface was much better, quite honestly. I mean, it was clunkier. It didn't look as good, kind of like Global Mapper, but it's a much better. It did far more. All right, so we've added that. Let's hit save. Got to hit save in this version. And now when we click on this, we get a picture and some nice little stuff. All right, now here's the coolest thing. It's kind of odd. You can also draw in here, like I said. You can draw lines. You can actually draw lines along roads, so that was another feature. You can export this. We'll go back to My Places. And if I click on this, it looks exactly the same, but I want to show you something. If we go back to My Places and we click on something we've saved before, for example, the Nyek Ladhaza I've saved before. Well, basically, excuse me. If it's got one of these new doobie dabbies, it's going to open in the new version, which is not what we want. However, if you've created it and imported it and only created it in this old version, see how it has a very different looking map icon? You'll be able to export it. So what we're going to do now, maybe Google's on to me. We're going to go up to here, and this is really weird, but you have to sign out and then sign right back in. Starting to feel like I found like a cheat for a video game or something. This is so over the top. This is all because Google doesn't want us to do this for free anymore. So now see Nyek Ladhaza revamped. Let's click on it. And now when you click on it, after logging out and logging back in, it doesn't matter how long you've logged out for, you'll have this KML option. And basically what that is it means we can download it. And so I'm going to download this and overwrite Nyek Gunk. And, oh, I got a phone interview. So, I'm going to pause this. I'll be right back. But I will show you my first cigarette. And it comes with the picture. All right, I got to answer this. Sorry, it's University of Chicago Press. Peace out.